What's up, guys? This is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure that you leave a like and subscribe for more video content. So we're going to continue where we left off in the last video, and we're going to go ahead and dive into the multi-location zoom. So we'll click this button and you get a dialog box that comes up. Okay. And in this dialog box, it's going to allow you to manipulate your coordinates in several different ways. So let's go ahead and get started. You can actually enter your coordinates in manually here. If you have a saved coordinate or you have it on a sheet of paper, you can just type it in and it will add that coordinate to the area down here. Or you can actually capture a coordinate with the capture coordinate button, which is right here. You click on this button and in your extent out here, you can click anywhere and it will add that coordinate into your area down here. So let's go ahead and click out here. All right, so what else can we do with this? Let's add some more coordinates. So let's click here and here and here and here and here. Okay, now we have six coordinates, right? Now you can also label these, and if you want to see all of these at once, all you need to do is click the show all markers button and you check this and it shows you all of your current markers that you have inside your multi-location zoom. All right, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so what else can we do here? Well, we can delete these one by one. We can just select, or we can delete them all at once. All right, so the next thing that I want to show you before I go too far into this is how to bring coordinates in from a CSV file. All right, so we can go ahead and trash these, get rid of all of them. And I'm going to bring in some coordinates from a CSV. Now, let me show you the CSV before I open it up with the multi-location zoom. So here's my CSV right here. And I have some addresses, some latitudes, and some longitudes. Okay, addresses, latitude, longitude. So this is the file that I'm going to bring in right now. I'll go to my open location list, click. And my MDS is the file I just showed you, and I'll go ahead and you can double click on this or you can single click and then press open, either one that works for you. Now let's go ahead and compare these lists here, and I can just scoop this over a little bit. Now what differences do you see between the list that I showed you and the list over here? Well, the first noticeable one is that these numbers here are not over here, or the way that these numbers are formatted are not over here at all. Okay, so what happened? Well, it's because I brought in my CSV in the wrong order. Okay, so the address would be the labels. So it would need to be behind the latitude and the longitude. So all I need to do to fix this is highlight this Excel field, and I'll cut it and I'll paste it over here. And I can just delete this one. Delete. All right, so I cut, I paste, I did all of these things. But how do I know that this is going to be how it's brought in? Well, you're going to have to save this document. Okay, save that change right here. Save it. And now when it brings it in, it will bring it in this way. So let's go ahead and take that down. We can trash all of these. And we'll bring that file in again, MDS, and I just double click it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and my labels. Okay, isn't that cool? All right, well, another thing that you can do is create a CSV this way. So let's go ahead and trash these. One error that you may run into if you bring in a CSV. And then let's say I add, like, I capture some other coordinates, and then I try to save this data into a new CSV. It is going to create a error for you. So let me show you what I mean. So you see that we have nine coordinates here. Let's go ahead and try to save this. And we'll just save this as new MDS. Save that. And now I will open that file. So let's go ahead and new MDS. Let's go ahead and open that in the Excel. Not in the QGIS. I'm opening it in an Excel document. And this is what we get right here. This is what we get. We get three little messed up coordinates. Now we had nine in total, so it's missing a whole lot of data there. But let's fix that problem. So how do we fix that? Well, let me exit out of that. What we do is we need to clear out these old imported coordinates. Okay, clear them out, all of them. I'll just select them like this, and I will delete those. And these are my coordinates that I actually want. So let me look at what those are. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I actually want to accidentally added that. Delete that. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now we have our nine again, but we got rid of the other imported data. Now with this, we can label these however we want. I'm not gonna go down and label all of these. I'm just gonna save this just to show you that it works. And I'm actually going to replace this CSV. Save. And I'm going to say yes. And now if I go out to my CSVs, this has been replaced. And I'll open this in my Excel. And now you see that I have nine correctly input coordinates that I can add labels or whatever else to. All right, so that is a problem that you may run into, and that's how you fix it. The next thing is with these good looking crosshairs out here, you can actually create a point layer from these crosshairs. All you need to do is press this create vector layer from location list. So if I press this, you will see that over here a new point layer has been created. Okay, Lat Lon locations. And if I take off the show all markers, you will see points. Now with these points, what does the attribute table look like for these points? Well, as you may have guessed, there is a field for latitude, longitude, and labels. So you can actually edit these in the multi-location zoom or in its attribute table. Let's go ahead and exit that and go back to my multi-zoom. And of course, it keeps these until you destroy or delete them. Okay, so let's go to the settings now that we've gone over all the buttons. Now in the settings for multi-zoom, we can edit change our CRS, okay, to whatever we want to use. We can go to change the order, which is Google Map, or you can change it to LON and then LAT. And then we can create different styles of .qml point vector styles. Now, .qml vector styles is kind of like if you've ever done website programming with CSS. It is a way to make a website more visually appealing. But anyway, I've never really got into the point or the .qml styles. I just keep my points regular. I know what it is, I know where it is, and that's it. But if you want to go into that, you can look further into that, but it's up to you. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.